welcome to Sweden.
Thank you.
That must have taken time, this hair thing.
Oh, no, I did it with my eyes closed.
We saw this video, She-Wolf. And I wonder, how do you invent these moves?
They just come to me by divine inspiration.
But it's not like you have a... You don't sit down and have a meeting and discuss, you know, yeah. What are we going to do now?
We make a blueprint? Yes. No, actually...
First of all, we need a cage.
Well, that is within the specifications, the technical specifications. But actually, I'm not a trained dancer. So I rely on my impulses, on my instinct. And whatever happened in that cage, I'm not responsible on. I was just taken by the moment, taken by the music, and when I least expected it, I was hanging from those bars, splitting, and doing all kinds of stuff.
You do belly dance as well. That
too.
That's more from your Lebanese side, or your...
I guess, you know. I guess it's in my DNA, right? Because nobody taught me.
Can anyone do belly dancing, or is it just...
Anyone. A Swedish guy like you could. If you try really hard. Absolutely. I can give you some lessons, but I'm very expensive.
Yes, well, I'm really not that interested, because it's been enough for me today, you know? I had this thing with Dolph, and could he do belly dancing?
I see body? The potential.
I think too much muscles, yeah. Don't you think?
Yeah. No, it helps, you know.
Are you a dancer?
No, just after a few tequila shots, I get pretty good.
This album of yours has the title She-Wolf, yeah. And it's a kind of philosophy behind that.
Yeah, well, I think that behind the word She-Wolf, there is a deeper interpretation of the culture that I've attempted to do. I think that society sometimes puts so much limitations upon women, you know, and upon human beings in general. I think that our existence is so brief. However, we spend our time building cages and instead of breaking free from them, you know. And I think that the She-Wolf is not only me, it's the woman of our time. I think it's a woman who rebels against all that. It's a woman who pursues her freedom and pursues her happiness. You know, and I think...
So this is kind of letting loose your animal side, or...?
That too, yeah. Well, I believe that there is a she-wolf in every woman, whether you guys like it or not. Yeah.
Are you aware of this?
Sure. Please agree with me.
Yes, I do.
There's nothing wrong in that, is there?
Absolutely
I've never
not.
Complained, but I'm not complaining.
Some guys might say...
The She-Wolf is welcome, anytime.
Yeah, you're welcome.
You know, some guys might get really excited about this statement, and some guys might just say, like, what's she talking about? Leave my woman alone, you know? But that's how it is, you know.
Society, what about your boyfriend? Has he learned to live with the animal? Or?
Well, he has to. He has to.
I can't believe I'm sitting here with a he-man and a she-wolf. who were you before this animal thing? I mean, who
was
were you before you found
this
she-wolf?
Well, I don't know.
Were there limitations that you feel you don't have today?
I feel closer to my own personal individuality, my own freedom, you know? I cannot say that I'm utterly free, because then I probably... that's probably a utopia, you know? I don't think we'll ever be in a completely free world, but... But human beings are getting closer and closer to that ideal, right? It's not only something that we sing about in anthems or in poems, or you know. I think it's a true, and we're trying really hard to reach out for a new individuality. And I think that maybe 10 years ago I was maybe more limited by you know, my neighbors, religion, the institutions, my family, my parents, my own consciousness, you know?
Ambition as well?
Yeah, ambition as well. Yeah, I guess. But ambition is a double-sided coin, you know? I think it can take you to places that you never expected that you could get to, you know? And it can also drive you mad. So it's, I think you gotta keep a balance. And if you're an ambitious person, it's very wise to have an analyst. I think that's why. I've been going to one for 8 years.
And what has he told you?
Sorry?
What has he or she told you?
He's a he. Well, he tells me many things, but I should not share him here. Not on national television. Anyway.
Not something I could use, is it?
He has fun. I think he has fun during the sessions.
And actually, you went back to school also a while ago.
I did, actually.
To UCLA?
To UCLA, yeah.
But how can Shakira come to UCLA? I mean, did you come in a burqa or some kind of... I mean, how do you do it?
That would have helped. That would have been a tremendous idea. Well, next time. I thought that it would be a great idea to study history of the Western civilization, because I love history. And I decided to go sort of in disguise, you know, with a cap and huge baggy pants and sneakers. And I looked like a boy, pretty much. So no one really recognized me. There were people who were suspicious, you know. They were, like, looking at me like I was an alien from outer space. But I was able to attend my classes and concentrate. And I was in and out, you know, like, in, take my notes and go. That's
how I did
it. I
see that people here in Scandinavia... When they are asked about Latin America, it's kidnapping, drugs, and Shakira.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
No, but they have these ideas. We don't know much about Latin America anymore.
Well, you should.
Absolutely, yes. Tell us.
Yeah. Well, I don't blame you guys, because, you know, we have unfortunately undergone so many conflicts over the past decades, you know, especially a country like Colombia, that has been, most of the population has been a victim of the lack of opportunities, you know. I mean, no child in the world wants to be a drug trafficker, if you ask him. No child will tell you, yeah, I want to be a criminal or a militant, you know. That is not in a child's mind. I mean, like I think it was Rousseau who once said, the man is born good, but society corrupts him. So I think that we have to give our children an opportunity.
And this is actually, you started a lot of schools, among other things. And this is how you spend your time when you're not in the cage doing those moves.
I can do those moves outside of the cage too. Just so you know.
Are you going to do them for us afterwards here when you do them?
Maybe if you behave.
You know, there are some expectations. you don't live in Colombia today.
I still have a house there. I still have family in Colombia, and I go back as often as I can because of the school, especially. I have these projects in Colombia that keep me really, really close to so many children there that expect something from me. So I'm always coming back, and every year we're understanding and learning more about the needs of our kids there. And yeah, we build schools in areas where there is no presence of the government or where there is not decent infrastructure. But the most important thing is that these schools also work as community centers. So it's not only for the kids who also learn and get nutritional meals, but it's also for the parents who also learn new occupations. And also they become very much involved with their kids' education. And these schools become like an oasis in the middle of extreme poverty. And it's about time that we invest in the foundation of our future.
Would you be a politician yourself? Yes?
Oh, I think, you know, that we should all be political, which means participating in the decisions of your nation and even the world. You know, I think it's an obligation, it's a duty, and it's also a right that we should all exercise. But now, being a politician, thank you, but no, thank you. I have better things to do.
No, but
or still, more fun things to do.
But when you speak about these things, and we just saw this video, and we hear this guy is a chemist, you know, and we just saw his film clip. It's you have quite a contrast in you. I mean, it's do you often feel that people have preconceived ideas when they meet you?
Maybe.
Who you are?
I don't really care, you know. I mean, I think that a woman's soul is like a diamond, right? And it has many facets. So you can't judge a woman just for one facet. We're not unidimensional. I mean, we can wear a short skirt, but we know what we're talking about, right?
That's a good thing.
Shakira, your band is waiting. And you're gonna do another song from the album.
Another song, yeah. My second single, it's called Did It Again.
Mm-hmm. And there are some moves there as well.
Well, you have to check out the video. It's interesting.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
I don't know if I can do all that now, but
absolutely.
If you're interested,
that's what we
part B, you can watch the video.
Please welcome Jada Pinkett Smith and Will Smith.